Just another post-election footnote. Remember I mentioned a number of times during the campaign that the media and left pile-on against Katherine Deves was deceptive? Really, a lot of the so-called transgressions of Deves were beat-ups and they were deliberate distortions. One repeated by a lot of media related to claims Deves had tweeted that half of all trans men were sex offenders. That was never the case, and anyone who quoted her tweet could see that she was referencing accurately a UK report about sex offenders in British jails, not talking about the whole population. Now, the public broadcaster SBS received a complaint over this and has apologised to Deves, admitting the reporting breached its code because it was inaccurate. Too little too late, of course, but at least they've done so, corrected the record and apologised. There are many other media organisations that ought to issue that same apology. But my point is this. Deves did apologise for a couple of instances where she went too far. But if the critics, those involved in the pile-on, say they're worried about divisive language, aren't they being deliberately divisive when they whip up resentment by being misleading, actually misleading people about what was actually said?